The aim of this laboratory experiment was to investigate the relationship between eye movements and dreaming. The study had three hypotheses. 1. There will be a significant association between REM sleep and dreaming. 2. There will be a significant positive correlation between the estimate of the duration of dreams and the length of eye movement. 3. There will be a significant association between the pattern of eye movement and the context of the dream. There were 9 participants in this study, 7 males and 2 females. 5 of these participants were studied intensively, whilst the other 4 were used to back up findings, and so were not studied as much. Participants arrived at the lab before their normal bedtime, but were instructed to avoid alcohol and caffeine. An EEG was used to amplify and record the signals from participants. 2 or more electrodes were attached near to the participants' eyes to record electrical changes caused by eye movement. Participants were woken up at random times during the night by a doorbell, and were then asked to speak into a tape recorder near the bed. From hypothesis 1, we can see the results show that REM sleep is predominantly, though not exclusively, associated with dreaming, and REM sleep is associated with periods of non-dreaming sleep. From hypothesis 2, awakenings that occurred revealed that NREALY all participants could accurately estimate the length of time that they had been dreaming. Results from hypothesis 3 show that there did appear to be some relationship between the dream content and the type of eye movements. For example, standing at the bottom of a cliff operating a hoist, and looking up at the climbers, and down at the hoist machinery. A problem with this study is ecological validity, the fact that it's not true to real life. Also, recent studies on sleep have obtained the same results as Ament and Kleitman did.